हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, लेट अस कंटिन्यू चैप्टर 8 इन साइंस, दैट इज मोशन. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस स्पीड विथ डायरेक्शन, इट मीन्स वेलोसिटी एंड एक्सेलेरेशन एंड फ्यू एग्जांपल्स. सो लेट अस स्टार्ट स्पीड विथ डायरेक्शन. द रेट ऑफ मोशन ऑफ एन ऑब्जेक्ट कैन बी मोर इफ यू स्पेसिफाई इट्स डायरेक्शन ऑफ मोशन अलॉन्ग विथ इट्स स्पीड. सो द क्वांटिटी that specifies both these aspects is known as velocity. Velocity is a vector quantity, and velocity is the speed of an object moving in a definite direction. The velocity of an object can be uniform or variable. It can be changed by changing the object's speed or the direction of motion, or we can say both. When an object is moving along a straight line at a variable speed, we can express the magnitude of its rate of motion in terms of average velocity. It is calculated in the same way as we calculate average speed. So, in case the velocity of an object is changing at a uniform rate, then average velocity is given by the arithmetic mean of initial velocity and final velocity for a given period of time. So, average velocity is equal to initial velocity plus final velocity divided by 2. Mathematically, we can say VAV, that is average. Velocity average is equal to U plus V upon 2, where U is initial velocity and V is final velocity. And speed and velocity have the same units, that is meter per second. Next example 8.2. The odometer of a car reads 2000 km at the start of a trip and 2400 km at the end of the trip. If the trip took 8 hours, calculate the average speed of the car in kilometer per hour and meter per second. So let us start. Actually, the distance covered by the car, that is S, as it is started with 2000 km and ends with 2400 km. So the total distance will be 2400 minus 2000 km. That means 400 km. And time taken, it took 8 hours. Therefore, 8. Then the average speed of the car will be, we have done V is equal to S upon T, equal to 400 km upon 8 hours. That means S is equal to 400 km and T is equal to 8 hours. And we'll get the answer 50 km per hour. Now we need to change it into meter per second. Then we will write 50 km per hour into 1000 meter divided by 3600 seconds. And the answer will be 13.9 meter per second. Next, example 8.3. Usha swims in a 90 meter long pool. She covers 180 meter in 1 minute by swimming from one end to the other and back along the same straight path. Find the average speed and average velocity of Usha. So let us start. Actually, total distance covered by Usha in 1 minute will be equal to 180 meter. As it is a 90 meter long pool, so from starting point to the ending point, she will cover 90 meter and again back to starting point, again 90 meter. Total 90 plus 90, which is equal to 180 meter. This is distance covered by Usha. But what about displacement? Displacement of Usha in 1 minute will be zero, because from initial point to ending point will be 90, and again from ending point to initial point 90, but in opposite direction. That's why the displacement will be 90 minus 90, which is equal to 0. So let us calculate average speed. Total distance covered upon total time taken, which is equal to 180 meters upon 1 minute. But we need to find the answer in seconds only. We will change minutes into seconds. Therefore, in the next step, it will be 180 meters upon 60 seconds, because 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds, and we will get the answer 3 meter per second as her average speed. But what about average velocity, which is equal to total displacement upon total time taken, which is equal to 0 upon 60, hence 0. Next, rate of change of velocity, that is acceleration. During uniform motion of an object along a straight line, the velocity remains constant with the time. In this case, the change in velocity of the object for any time interval is 0. However, in non-uniform motion, velocity varies with time. It has different values at different instants and at different points of the path. Thus, the change in velocity of the object during any time interval is not 0. So, we have to introduce another physical quantity known as acceleration, which is a measure of the change in velocity of an object per unit time. That is, acceleration is equal to change in velocity upon time taken. If the velocity of an object changes from an initial value u to the final value v in time t, the acceleration a is equal to v minus u upon t. The kind of motion is known as accelerated motion. The acceleration is taken to be positive if it is in the direction of velocity and negative when it is opposite to the direction of velocity. The SI unit of acceleration is meter per second square. If an object travels in a straight line and its velocity increases or decreases by equal amounts in equal intervals of time, then the acceleration of the object is said to be uniform. The motion of a freely falling body is an example of uniformly accelerated motion. On the other hand, an object can travel with non-uniform acceleration if its velocity changes at a non-uniform rate. For example, if a car traveling along a straight road increases its speed by unequal amounts in equal intervals of time, then the car is said to be moving with non-uniform acceleration. So, students, I hope you understood this topic. Thank you for listening.